Hi, I'm Mo, and I'm here to tell you about 5 fun things in Fedora 12. Cheese is a fun tool that lets you play around with your webcam. You can take photos, you can take multiple photos at once in a burst, or you can take movies with it, and you can also apply special effects. So, for example, you can turn yourself into the Hulk. Or you can trip out. There's a lot of different effects, and you can combine them all at the same time, which sometimes results in kind of an interesting picture, but you get the idea. And every time you take a photo, let me reset this to normal. Every time you take a photo, it ends up in a little bar along the bottom. There it is. And then all your photos are also stored in your home directory, in the pictures webcam directory. So they're always there, and you don't even have to open up Cheese to access them. And you can right-click and open them right away, or you can even edit them up in the GIMP. So, we're talking about fun things in Fedora. This is one thing that really surprised me. This is a completely free and open source multiplayer online role-playing game called Mana World. And it's all the artwork, all the whole game, it's all open source, which I think is really awesome. So it comes right in Fedora. Here's my little character. I haven't really done very well for myself because I haven't been playing very long, but this is such a cool game, and you can walk around, and I'm only a little person in this game so far. I don't have a lot of money, so I haven't been able to really dress up my character and customize her yet, but as you play through the game, you'll meet different people, and there's different monsters you kill to make money, and then based on how much money you make, you can buy different things. Right now, I can only kill these little maggot guys. But when you kill them, you get maggot slime, and you can sell that for gold coins that you can then use to buy cool stuff. So, I still have a long way to go in this game, but I'm just fascinated by the fact there's this online role-playing game that's completely open source, so. So, in Fedora, we have this program called Miro. And it's a program that will help you organize both video and audio podcasts, or if they're video, they're vodcasts. And it's a really nice way to organize your shows. It has a little sidebar here where you can see here's all my videos in my library that I've downloaded. And you can see I'm trying to learn Blender, so I have a lot of training videos for Blender. But these videos are all free, which is great. I mean, here, if you wanted to use the GIMP and you wanted to learn more about the GIMP, there's this show called Meet the GIMP, and I've been watching that a lot lately. There's some really cool stuff in it. And I believe Miro uses BitTorrent to download these when available. But you can also, if you know the URL of a video file, you can download it directly using Miro as well, and it'll add it to your Miro library, which makes it really easy to watch. And it also lets you see sites. I can watch The Daily Show right from Miro. It adds the Hulu page there, so I can just click on it right away. Tablet support is better than ever in Fedora 12. Whether you have a built-in tablet into your monitor, the way I have with my ThinkPad X61 here, or if you have an external USB tablet, such as one of the Wacom tablets, you'll have a seamless experience from install to usage. I installed Fedora 12 fresh on this machine, and I didn't have to check off any extra things, I didn't have to do any additional configuration, and I have pressure-sensitive tablet support right out of the box. So, I wanted to show you a few cool tools that we have in Fedora 12 that work great with your tablet and will make it more enjoyable to use. So here, I'm just opening up a run-of-the-mill text editor. This is called gedit. And I'm also going up to the system tray here, and I'm opening CellWriter. Now, CellWriter is a handwriting recognition application. So, as you can see, I had just written Fedora. As I write in my handwriting, it recognizes the characters I'm writing and it converts them to text. And then if I hit enter here, then they end up in my document. Now obviously this is not the matter in which you're going to want to write your opus or the next War and Peace, but at the same time it's very handy if you have your tablet flipped out so that you don't have the keyboard and you need to write something quick. For example, when I'm drawing, when I'm using the tablet for doing digital painting and I want to save my work, I don't want to have to flip open my keyboard just to write in the file name I want to save it as. This is great for just writing little chunks like that. Here's another great tool for you tablet users in Fedora 12. It's called Xernal. I think I'm pronouncing it right. But either case, it's a great little tool to take notes, handwritten notes. So here, I've got the pencil tool. And it has a little highlighter tool too. And you can change colors if you like. Pink is definitely my favorite. It even has a little shape recognizer. It can be a little picky though. Actually, I turned it off. Here we go. You see how it recognizes the shape I'm drawing and it turns it into a perfect shape. For the most part. And it's just, it's really nice to be able to take notes and not have to whip out your keyboard. I find it very useful when I'm taking usability test notes. And what happens is after you take a page of notes, you can go up here and start a new page of fresh notes, as many pages as you need. And then you can save them out as a PDF file, they're just really easy to share with people. Actually, you're gonna do file, export to PDF. And makes your notes very portable, you can print them out, it's wonderful. Another thing you can do, and I love this is a copy of Pride and Prejudice from Project Gutenberg. But, you know, say you're reading a book or something, you wanted to highlight passages, you know, and you can write notes in the margin. And then you can save a copy of the book with your notes on it, but you can also maintain the clean copy as well, just in case you need it. So you can print out your notes right in context, which is great. Another way that Xernal is a great application to use is if you have to fill out forms and sign them, like when I was getting a mortgage pre-approval, that was one thing that came in handy because my real estate agent sent me the form. And all I had to do is just sign it and then save it out. And it worked really conveniently. Because, you know, normally you have to print it out on paper, sign it with pen, scan it back in, convert it to PDF, and then email it. And by the time you're done with that, you've wasted 20 minutes to half an hour. So Xernal is just a great little tool to work with your tablet. Now I'd like to show you how Fedora 12 will help you express your artistic urges using your tablet. So here I have the application called the GIMP open up, and this is pretty much the open source premier bitmap graphics editor, and it's also great for just doing paint jobs, digital painting and icon art and things like that. So here I have selected the brush tool, and I have a bunch of brushes here, and some of these, you know, I installed from various places online. Actually, a great feature of GIMP is you can install Photoshop brushes in GIMP, so you don't need to find GIMP-specific brushes, but there's also a lot